Assalamu alaikum, guys. My name is Tahir Khan, and I'm looking to raise £50,000 to have the world's first of its kind Halal Monitoring Committee HMC approved beef jerky brand called Tahir Halal Beef Jerky here in the UK. The HMC organization is an independent non-profit registered charity which monitors, inspects and certifies halal products for the benefits of the Muslim community. HMC is a true blessing for all the Muslims as it is the most trusted organization in the UK, which has been supported by 600 masjids and high Muslim denominations and scholars. I'm looking to raise £50,000 to buy two commercially graded dehydrators, packaging plant, packaging materials, and to hire a commercial venue where the jerky slicing, marinating, cooking, and packaging would be carried out under my supervision. I am a jerky lover myself and consume or eat beef jerky after my gym workouts, but why does halal matter? Consuming and eating halal is one of the most important tenets of Islamic faith, and alhamdulillah, I am a Muslim. Consuming non-halal products, especially meat, would put our prayers and actions at risk, and our prayers might remain unanswered. That's why, as a Muslim, whatever we eat and consume is of vital importance to us. Mashallah, there are 1.8 billion Muslims around the globe, and halal is like a big, massive industry. Especially in the UK, halal meat industries are based on trust. Unfortunately, there has been many incidents over the past years that halal meat and poultry has been falsely labeled. Halal and its associated Arabic symbol has become an abused word, and the sign is not protected by the law, by UK law, I should better say, and the UK government. So the word halal has been misused equally by Muslims and non-Muslims. Word halal being displayed everywhere without any regulation, Muslim consumers are led to believe that the products they are consuming or eating are halal, when unfortunately on many cases these products are not. According to research, statistics shows that over 90% of halal labeled meat and poultry in the UK are in doubt. Study reveals shocking kebabs. BBC News program, which was broadcasted in January 2009, shocking news of halal kebab containing pork. In May 2003, Panorama broadcasted and revealed that the processed chicken products were injected with enzymes and beef from pork shipped from different countries, including some European countries, to the UK. Unfit meat seized by police in Yorkshire. In Evening Post, it was published in March 2008, the meat being unfit and was sold as halal. I love beef jerky. At this stage, you guys might be asking, what's so special about this beef jerky? And why am I just making this beef jerky, which is backed by HMC or Halal Monitoring Committee? This beef jerky that I would like to introduce to the world is the first of its kind. The meat that we acquire and use in our beef jerkies are obtained from HMC registered abattoirs and suppliers in supply chain, where the animals are slaughtered with HMC universally accepted halal criteria. The animals are slaughtered by trained Muslim slaughtermen, and trained HMC inspectors are present there at all times in abattoirs and in cutting and processing plants as well, where they observe the compliance of HMC's halal standard in real time, giving assurance that the products in question are meeting with the ethics of halal. We would assure our customers to go ahead and consume our products with 110% confidence that these are purely halal. In the West, most of the people, including myself, was falsely or blindly eating halal. As mentioned before, that according to research, statistics shows that 90% of the halal labeled meat and poultry in the UK are in doubt. In the UK alone are in doubt. But that's why I wanted to introduce a beef jerky, or make a beef jerky, which is 110% halal, not only for myself to consume, but for thousands and millions of other Muslim consumers, not only here in the UK, but all around the world, to whom halal does matter. Why HMC approved meat suppliers, and in this instance, Tahir's Halal Beef Jerky, is a very, very big deal for me, because I love consuming beef jerky myself, and I just basically use them right after my gym sessions. And I got doubts about the other jerkies made by different sort of brands, and the sticker of halal only stuck on its cover doesn't mean it come or it came or originated or been slaughtered by Muslim slaughtermen following Islamic ethics. Hopefully with your support we can make this dream project to turn into reality. Every penny counts, so any contribution you make will bring me one step closer to making this dream project a reality, which would enable us launching here in the UK successfully to make these authentic 110% halal delicious meat beef jerkies available in your hometowns, in your corner shops near you, in the gas stations where you fill your car, and in the supermarkets where you do your daily and weekly shopping. Our bigger plan is to end up in the shelves of the supermarket giants like Tesco's and Sainsbury's over here in the UK. Once we are there, we would like to expand in the US, Gulf, and European markets to make them available to Muslims and non-Muslims alike. I truly believe in this product, and it would gain a big market share quickly, as it would be consumed with confidence by non-Muslims and by Muslims for whom their iman matters. I'm open to creative collaborations too, so if you want to get involved, get in touch and let's talk. I hope that together we can co-create and propagate a lovely product that will be the best protein snacks of its kind with authentic halal flavors that would have a massive impact in the market at this significant moment of time. Thank you for watching and God bless you all.